Hey everybody, this is Pastor Megan. I'm coming to you from Minnesota, out near Pipestone. That's my stepfather, Dave, out there planting some seeds. It's finally getting dry enough to try to plant some of the fields out here. And I thought I would tell you a little bit about the story of the sower who went out to sow. So there is a sower, that means a guy who plants seeds. He goes out, he throws the seeds or something, because some of them land on good soil, some of them land on rocky soil, some of them land in bad soil, and some of them are eaten by birds. And a lot of people focus on where the seeds end up landing. It's a story about how sometimes people who are vulnerable, people who are the least expected to do well, are the ones that grow and thrive, and you can't really figure out who's going to be what until you wait and see what grows. It's about giving people a chance, and it's about waiting to see what's unexpected. But I think a really fun aspect of this story, particularly because, you know, Dave's back there on his tractor, Dave would never go out to this field and just start throwing seeds around. Even back in the homesteading days, they would never just throw the seeds around. They went with a plow and an oxen, and for days and days and days, dug holes where to put the seeds. It's really bad farming to just throw seeds. And when seeds go afoul, if they're landing on rocks and on bad soil, it's the sower's fault, not the seeds. You'd never blame the seeds for not growing. And so it leads to the question, if this world is created to be one of free will, who's to blame for when things go wrong? Is it our fault? Is it the Creator's fault because the world is so crazy, because we're put into soil that never was meant to grow? If we are born in poverty and don't have as many opportunities to grow as people who are rich, is it our fault? Is it community's fault? Is it the Creator's fault? I've heard a lot of stories of people who are upset about how chaotic the world is and why a God would allow it to exist. It's a question that has existed forever. I don't have an answer to that, except for anger is a rational fear, and you can find that in scripture too. But what I do want to talk about today is that we are people who can grow. God is a creator that apparently makes mistakes as well. There's a number of places in the Bible where God changes God's mind and does things a new way. And so you can change, and God can evolve, and love is hard, but let's try anyway. Here comes Dave to say hi. There he is. Maybe we'll ask him why a sower go to sow and throw seeds that way. Let's see what he says. All right, so you're planting seeds, right? So what, in the story in the Bible, where the sower goes out to sow and the seeds go in all kinds of weird places, like in the rocks and in the sand, is that the farmer's fault or is it the seed's fault?
Well, I suppose it's a farmer because he throwed them there.
That's right. That's what I thought.
It's the seed's fault.
That's right.
The seeds would have stayed in the bag.
That's right.
Yes.
Thanks. That's what I thought. Well, it is an interesting way to look at the Bible study. Finding out who's to blame for what's going wrong is never going to solve any problems. And so the question is, knowing that things are broken, knowing that things are chaotic, knowing that our life is hard and love is hard, how are we going to live is a question we need to refocus ourselves to. So in the midst of a desire to grow and not everything growing the way we'd like, in the midst of well-laid plans that don't always go the way that we like, health that gets in the way, and relationships that are just tougher than we imagined, how can we live each day so others can grow, so we can grow, and so that the love of God can grow in the world? And my only answer for that is to love boldly and forgive more boldly still. Love boldly because God loves you boldly. No matter how you end up, whatever choices you make, no matter what happens, God loves you and names you and claims you. And heck, so do I. And forgive more boldly, because we can't hang on to what's not going wrong, not going right. We can't hold on to difficulty, and we can't live in that blame land. So forgive for the sake of moving on and moving towards growth. I love y'all. Take care.